This guy. Me and this guy don't get along.
I hope you know it.
After Karim Adeyemi decided to start the line outside my office door a day before the Europa League final and demanding Champions League football despite us qualifying for it already, things remained rocky into the new season. Look, I know that they say footballers aren't the smartest blokes out there, but this is moronic on a different level. Then all of a sudden, Spurs were interested in buying him, and Adeyemi had the nerve to walk into my office once more and ask to move to Spurs. They finished 8th. The reason changed too. It went from not enough playing time to playing in the Champions League to playing in a better league. My guy, you've been here for 2 seconds. If you want to leave, your agent put a release clause in your contract for £71 million. However, he wasn't even smart enough to figure that out. He wanted to settle on a fee he could be sold for, and he chose £87 million. Oh, you think you're worth $87 million? I would have been alright getting rid of him because he hasn't been doing as well as I would have hoped. However, no one bidded for him, and I started getting these evil thoughts in my head of keeping him on the bench, maybe sending him to the second team and rot in the reserves, those type of things. Maybe I should have thought of how I would improve the team, as the Bundesliga season wasn't normal. It was so weird that Arminia Bielefeld got in the top 4.
What?
This season we were given a lot of money to spend, and while most smart managers wheel and deal and get the best value for their buck,
I'm gonna go bold.
I spent $64 million on Josh Kovardiol to make sure that we had the best and fastest center backs around. Byron still probably had that though. Then I brought in a Ghanaian named Fatavu because he looked good and was cheap, and I also bought this new gent who I thought I could mold into a great left back. Then I realized later on the season that his 2 jumping reach was a massive miss by me. On the outs, Fosu Mensah officially left the club to Hoffenheim and Amin Adli left for Paderborn. There were some loans, including our captain, just jumping off the ship, a disgrace. In January, I decided to spend $29 million on a 17-year-old. Why? Just have a look. The man has been playing professional football since he was 15, so I sent him on loan to Augsburg to worry about him next year, but he looks incredible already. Good news is that finally, Dortmund sold Haaland.
Yes! Yes!
He moved to Liverpool for £120 million, which seemed a little low for a 2-time Ballon d'Or make that 3-time Ballon d'Or winner. The season started off great with 3 wins in a row. Plus, we even defeated Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. Unfortunately, it just got worse from there. The schedule makers decided to give us Bayern in our 4th match, and Danilo decided to get a red card right before halftime. And soon, poor form followed. The Dortmund match had me in pure rage, as we gave away this goal.
We conceded stupid goals.
And despite me coming back and scoring in the last minute, Dortmund ended up scoring this in the last second.
It's just stupid.
Then in back-to-back Bundesliga matches, we got red cards. I had enough and took off the get stuck in. Suddenly, there weren't any red cards for the rest of the season. However, there were broken legs.
Help! Help! My leg!
2 of them, to 2 of my best players. The $64 million signing is out the window, and Guiri, who eventually became happy to stay after, was forced to stay anyways because he couldn't walk. Despite all of these problems, we did end up finishing 2nd in our Champions League group, but the Bundesliga became a mess in December. Thank goodness for the break. Let's get back to Adeyemi. In the early parts of the season, he was useless and barely played. However, in the DFB Pokal 2nd round, I gave him a start against Stuttgart, and they were giving me more problems than I expected. They scored a goal, we scored a goal. They took the lead, we tied it back up, we finally went ahead, and once again, they scored as well. Adeyemi is already on 2 goals at this point, and I kept him in the match, and in the 89th minute, he repays me by scoring his hat trick. A massive result which led him back into my good books. He would start more matches, score more goals, and be happy enough to sign a new contract. Wages are a little high though.
Good business.
Now, Bayern Munich at this period were ridiculous. While we Bundesliga peasants were all struggling, it took Bayern 15 matches to finally drop points in the league. They didn't even drop a single match in all competitions until late November. Mbappe balled out and Lewandowski was still being Robert. It was so annoying to see, but what can you do? Maybe beat them? The new year came and there was a mirrored performance from the first half of the season. We won the first 3 matches and then had Bayern. We were actually 3-1 up with a man advantage, and then I decided to tinker. They tied it in the 90th minute, and the Bundesliga would not be a fun ride. Although, a big part of that was the cups. The Champions League round 16 gave us Manchester City, led by Vincent Kompany. What happened to Guardiola?
I'm so upset because they didn't invite me.
Oh, is that Chelsea now? Guess he needs to be at a team with a lot of money. Kompany played a 4-4-2, and after 15 minutes of the match, I decided to drop Wirtz into a roaming playmaker role as I could see us overloading their midfield. Kompany's brain couldn't comprehend that, so it was a beautiful situation. Oh, we scored! Let's go! We were winning 1-0, then that damn Gabriel Jesus came on and equalized in the 90th minute. But then, just minutes later, after being out for months with a broken leg, Weary, who came off the bench for the first appearance in 4 months, had something to say. Can you find someone? That's good. Is that good? Please? Yes! A 2-1 win in the first leg and a 2-2 draw in the second had us advance. Although they probably deserved more than a 2-2 draw in that second leg, but I don't care. We drew Zebras, and got an emphatic win over them in the home leg. 3-0, job done. Even though they tried their very best in the second leg and annoyingly won the game late, it wasn't enough as, yes, Leverkusen made the Champions League semi-final. Who would we face?
Paired with another team. Holland.
The DFB poll call was also a ride. We were taken to penalties by Hanover, who were in the second division. Thankfully, we had a positive ending this time. Another late goal from Guiri gave us a victory over Hoffenheim, which led to Bayern in the semi-final. Could we replicate season 1's result? Well, our left back decided to go on a run and score a 1-1 to give us an early lead. However, I don't know what went on in the 78th minute, but we, for some reason, only had one player back for a corner kick. Bayern countered, Sané was sent free, and we ended up going to extra time. Unfortunately, Bayern were too much and deservedly went to the final. The Champions League semi-final is actually what I care about, and in the first leg, we pulled it off from, of course, Adeyemi. Oh my gosh, we scored against Liverpool! With a second leg approaching, I was bricking it. We just drew Wolfsburg, putting us in 5th place with one match remaining in the league.
Oh no.
We also had to visit Anfield for the second leg of the semi-final. Tell me where I've heard that before. They also won this competition for 2 years in a row, without Haaland. So... Haaland, sexy Bayern Hammer. Maybe on most nights I would have a chance, but most nights don't have Erling Haaland. I was down bad. I lost 2 semi-finals. I'm gonna likely miss the Champions League spots unless Wolfsburg somehow crapped the bed. Oh, they're playing Dortmund? Well, that was easy.